Hello, wrestling fans, and welcome to another edition of Fire and Ice Wrestling Meltdown. I'm your host, Liverpool's greatest athlete and the Queen's favorite wrestler, not to mention the current Fire and Ice Wrestling United States champion, the rugby thug, Trent Baker. On this week's show, you will see clips from the very first ever Fire and Ice Wrestling Awards Banquet, an annual awards banquet. And tonight, you will see such Fire and Ice Wrestling superstars as Prodigy, The One, Marcus Dillon, Shank Dorsey, Viper, David Starr, and many others. And you will also see the greatest manager in professional wrestling, Luscious John Ellery. So at this time, we'd like to take you to our first award. A lot of people were in the running for best hair.
Oh, we know what that's saying.
Now, there were a lot of it argue. Of course, Prodigy was in the running. Viper. Now, Tank made a strong showing in the last few weeks. But when it all was said and done, all the voting was in, it came out that the one Marcus Dillon got the best hair in Fire and Ice Wrestling. Come on down. Congratulations. I'll have you know we talked with Denise, the official hairdresser, and she was highly recommending you. Here, look at the camera, you're nice. Okay, that's enough. Address the constituents for just a moment.
Well, you heard it now.
I'd like to thank Denise for taking care of my hair over the last couple months, and I'd like to thank the Big Dillonite upstairs for blessing me with the genetics to have better hair than anybody here.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Look at the nominees for Manager of the Year. It was very, very tricky. There was, of course, the Don King pen from 1999. There were a couple other, you know, Mr. Breeze and some other folks that were involved. A lot of people pointed at the bad boy, Brady West, who was not in attendance here tonight. But when it was all said and done, it did come down to the Luscious One, the Park Place Tycoon, John Ellering, as the manager of the year, ladies and gentlemen. John, congratulations.
No, congratulations. I deserve it.
Absolutely. Couldn't agree more.
This is for the man who's got the best of everything. The Rolex, the diamond rings, and the best wrestler anybody could ever have. So, I thank all of you.
Like to say anything to everyone?
Nah.
Any word nice. Yeah, when we begin to look at finishing maneuver of the year, a lot of possibilities came to bear. Very few wrestlers have ever donned Fire and Ice Wrestling Studio at all without having at least one, and the majority having...
I just talking to Michael.
At least one, but the majority having a lot in their arsenal and at least a couple finishers. As we began to look at things and put these together, internet voting came into play. Success rate with your finisher came into play. A lot of things came to pass. We looked at Tank's Spinebuster, which I've never seen another move personally inches before my eyes actually give someone a concussion before, but...
You know what I'm like.
But that was pretty devastating. We obviously looked at Prodigy's Kamikaze, we looked at Commodore's Compactor, we looked at a lot of moves. When we put it all together, it came up. You could have flipped the coin. There were about three that were right on top. When it was all said and done, it was the Star of David from David Starr that took the thing home. David Starr has the rookie of the year.
Yeah! Woo! Woo!
This time you've got to tell people some things. This is the second one of these. This is beginning to be habit for me. What do you think? What do you know?
Well, I'll be back soon, and I won't let the fans down. I appreciate the voting. Thanks.
Woo!
Cowards, then it's gonna be quick. All your men have been to jail before. Suck my quick. Get done with it. Dumb quick.
Hello, wrestling fans, and welcome back to Fire and Ice Wrestling Meltdown. On the show, you're watching the annual awards banquet, which was held at the Old Spaghetti Warehouse this year. Now, let's go back to the presentation.
Okay, there was a lot of speculation and a lot of individuals in the running for this next award. It was for the Fire and Ice Wrestling Hottie of the Year.
David Starr.
And I don't want to disappoint anybody, but unfortunately, David Starr came up a little shy.
What?
Oh, man.
Overdraft. Where's the Rebo.
So anyway, a lot of people took a lot of votes. This is one of the most voted polls on the internet.
Woo-hoo!
One of the most feedback-related situations we've had in a long time.
Winner is Mark Stone.
And unfortunately, I didn't take it home, I'm sorry. But the person who did take it home is here tonight, and it is Prodigy.
Thank you, boy! Thank you, boy!
This world make me look so good.
Thank my mom for making me so pretty. And thank
all the ladies.
Thank both of the ladies for my healthy
skin. Yeah, all the ladies out there, thanks a lot. But no, seriously, actually the two most poor ladies in the world to me are in the room. It's not funny.
Now you're
my
really
mom
funny.
And
and
Jenny. She's forced me through everything. She's my best friend in the world. And, that's Jennifer to marry me tonight.
No, it's perfect.
just goes to show you, absolutely, positively, anything can happen right here in FIW.
Good thanks to my best friend in the world. Ask Jennifer to marry me tonight. When we begin to take a look at the nominees for best mic work, best on the stick, there were a lot of people that came to mind. Myself, I humbly acknowledge, but I took myself out of the voting to be fair. A lot of people are really good, and a lot of people have improved a lot since we started or since they came in, whichever the case may be. But when everything was said and done, it was pretty unanimous that the one man that holds things together on the stick under all circumstances and continues to impress everyone doing it is the rugby thug, Trent.
Well, it's definitely a hard act to follow, but I'll try anyways, you know. Who would ever thought that a young poor boy from Liverpool, England, could come to this country, not only be the Fire and Ice Wrestling United States Champion, but also best on the stick. I'd like to thank my manager, Luscious John, Manager of the Year. I'd like to thank Mark Stone and all the fans. Thank you.
Tonight, match of the year. There were a lot of things to look at in this too, especially a lot of people don't understand or realize when we first started in 99, in late 99, the guys that came in, really the only one that really had even the remotest clue of what they're doing in the ring was Bryan Lucky. And he nursed the people that we had at the time. Some are still here, some aren't. But a lot of credit needs to go to him. Because when you look at these guys' matches, they're certainly not going to be in any danger of the original Burn the Bridge or No Limits, of being confused with Rob Van Dam. But at the same time, for a couple of them, 2 to 3 weeks is all they had between the ropes. And for what they had experience-wise, they were certainly delivering. All of that said, all of those good things piled up, still didn't quite measure up to the excitement at the beginning of August that was generated between Shank Dorsey and Prodigy in what we've now learned is the FIW match of the year. Both you guys, one at a time, can come on down.
Just Mark said, Nathan definitely makes us look a hell of a lot better than what we really do if you're there live. So thanks God to him. Big round of applause for Nathan. Even though he is a fat, toothless bastard, if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be up here either, so. Shaggy Dorsey helped me through everything. He taught me from the beginning, so. He's the man. Thanks.
Congratulations, my man.
Just want to say I didn't do it by myself. I had Prodigy to beat up on, so that made it a lot easier for me. But you guys think it was match of the year. I personally do not. There's a lot better match in me than what you guys saw. And one of these days, you guys are going to see it. And personally, I just came here for the Paschetti. Thank you.
guys, that's all the time we have for this week's show. Make sure to join us September 30th at the Media Play East from 2 to 4 p.m. so you can see me give that Southern Knight Bryan Blade a bloody good thrashing. And September 30th, I will knock your bloody head off.
Tonight's been all about fun, you know, somebody's getting married, people shaking hands, getting all excited about stuff. Dylanites, be prepared for September 30th. Stu Hansen, you want to run your mouth about the one and about Shank Dorsey? You bring your mid-card, no talent, nobody knows you outside of Columbus ass, the Media Play on September 30th, and you will find out why he is the Orient Express Shank Dorsey.
You know that's right.
And you'll find out why I am simply the one.
It was a good night for Lucian Star myself. I won an award, he won an award. You know, still U.S. champion, most dominant U.S. champion in the history of Far Ice Wrestling.
Anything like that, Joe?
Well, not really. I mean, you said it all. I've got the best U.S. champion in the world. I was keeping for a long time, and ain't nothing or anything anybody's going to do about it.
Cabbage is a vegetable.
I don't know.
and for those who would not care for cabbage.
Strawberries are fruit.
And for those who will only accept beef with no imitations.
And I'd say, it's all gone, Mark Stone hated. You ain't getting it back.